Moving on to more company earnings now, DMCI Holdings sees a 20% decline in its full-year net income in 2023. Profits stood at 25 billion pesos from the 31.1 billion in 2022. Revenues were also lower by 14%. DMCI points to sharp corrections in commodity and energy prices for the weaker performance. It said, though, that better production and sales volume helped prevent deeper losses. Atlas Mining also significantly lower profit last year. Net income after tax dropped by 65% to 1.1 billion. It attributes the decline to lower copper prices and the recognition of a one-time gain on early loan payment. Finally, Finma Corporation emerging stronger from 2023. It capped the year with core net income higher by 40% to 1.67 billion pesos. Revenues also jumping by 20% to over 21 billion. Finma says the sustained growth in its education business as well as in construction and property drove its stronger performance. So the Philippines Special Committee on the West Philippine Sea urging the Marcos administration to file another diplomatic protest against China. This after water cannon attack launched by Chinese Coast Guard vessels in the disputed territory injured 4 Philippine Navy personnel. The committee says doing so may inspire other countries to rally behind Manila in its maritime dispute with Beijing.
Calling on the ang ating gobyerno na to file a diplomatic protest about this. Nagpapahayag tayo sa buong mundo na hindi natin gini-give up ang ating stand dyan sa West Philippine Sea. Dahil kasi at ito nakakatulong ng yung postura natin niya na hindi pag-give up, nakakatulong at naiinganyo ang ibang mga bansa na meron ding interest dyan sa lugar na yan na tumulong sa atin sa pamamagitan ng pag-condemn din sa pagsuporta sa ating bansa at pag-condemn din sa ginagawang bullying ng China.
China, for its part, stood by the actions of its Coast Guard. Its Chinese Foreign Ministry argues their Coast Guard only took restrained and lawful action against Philippine vessels. It also accuses Manila of provocations, and the allegations earned the ire of the Philippines' National Security Council, which asserts Manila is unfazed by China's provocation.
If the hope of China is to weaken the Philippine resolve, they will be sorely disappointed, because we will never be deterred from exercising our legal rights over our maritime zones, including Ayungin Shoal, which forms part of our EEZ, that the Philippines is, and I quote, untrustful, deliberately stirring up trouble, and maliciously inciting hate. Let me ask them this question. Who is executing the blocking and dangerous maneuvers? Who is deploying water cannons against unarmed ships? Is hurting or causing injury to Filipino personnel, professional and legitimate? Who is deliberately blocking our ships in waters where the Philippines exercises sovereign rights and jurisdiction under international law? Is it the Philippines? No, it is China.